One man's trash is enough to power another man's home, and a bunch of it could power 20,000 homes. So what are we waiting for? Hey there, trashy people. Trace here for D News. Thanks for watching. You guys, a company called GreenSky is taking in sorted municipal and commercial waste and outputting jet fuel from it. Yeah, trash to airplane fuel. Boeing flew a 787 using biofuel last year just to prove that they could do it. But GreenSky, they want to make enough fuel from trash to supply all of the needs for London City Airport. British Airways has pledged to purchase all 50,000 metric tons of fuel from GreenSky. They're gonna fly all over using your trash for fuel and also charge you to put their bags in the bins. But not the trash bins, the overhead bins. Look, trash is everywhere. We throw away 4.3 pounds of waste every day, and 55% of all the trash generated in the US goes into landfills. But according to Scientific American, if we converted the 460 million tons of trash produced in North America properly, we could make 12.4 billion gallons of ethanol. It's a lot of hooch. Roughly the same amount as produced by all ethanol-bound corn. And the process is actually really easy. All you need is to unleash some sulfuric acid to break down the cellulose, and then some select enzymes and microbes to ferment the resulting slurry into fuel. Done. You're flying. Biofuel from trash is great, but we also need to separate that trash before we can do that. So while we use that in the future, we can also burn grandpa's trash too. In 1986, there were over 7,600 small dumps in the US. Today, there are around 1,900 mega dumps, which should have enough capacity for centuries of garbage. In 2008, power from landfills exceeded solar power production in New York and both solar and wind in New Jersey, and it's expanded significantly in the last 7 years. Of those 1,900 landfills, over 640 have added the technology to harness the power of landfill gases, or LFGs, and convert that gas into energy. LFG is produced by anaerobic bacteria, bacteria that doesn't need oxygen, and it's buried deep within landfills. The anaerobic bacteria munch on our trash and then poop out methane, which would normally be really, really bad. Methane is 20 times more potent a greenhouse gas than CO2, and according to the EPA, municipal solid waste is the third largest source of human-related methane emissions in the US. But if we capture it before it floats up and makes climate change way worse, we can use it for good and chillax with some of that oil burning too. Methane is an odorless, colorless hydrocarbon, CH4. And because the bacteria are trapped underground, companies can find pockets of this methane and suck it out with high vacuum pipes. Once collected, the methane is cooled, cleaned, and mixed with mercaptan to give it a detectable odor before they send it out to natural gas plants to be burned for fuel. Yeah, natural gas can come from rock or oil deposits, but it's 99% methane with some propane, ethane, and sulfur and helium all mixed in. The biomass methane is pretty much just CH4, because bacteria are good like that. The EPA's Landfill Methane Outreach Program is hoping to encourage companies to set up on top of landfills and suck in as much methane as possible, because otherwise we're literally just letting dollars float away. As of 2013, LFG captured energy was powering 1.8 million homes. So just to recap, we throw away a lot of stuff and then we just let it sit there. But thanks to these technologies, getting trashy could maybe clean up the world. So what do you think we should do with our trash? How about this? Click here and watch Julian's episode on how Sweden is doing it right and burning their trash, maybe surprising, or click here and watch my episode about why shooting nuclear waste at the sun is a great idea. Thanks for watching D News, everybody. Make sure you subscribe so you get all of our videos every day, and we'll see you next time.